Welcome back, Sports Chat.
The 503 Southeast.
Today it's interesting. We're talking about some crazy stuff here.
Yeah, it is.
Big stuff. Today, sponsored by the guy who heard at some point a political theory that he jumped on and identified himself as that political theory. And then for the rest of his life, promoted that political theory as being the only way to go. And then gets to the point about maybe 70 years old and was like, what? Should I have gone to the other, maybe done that somewhere else? We are a country that you can decide to be a Republican or Democrat every single time you vote.
Yeah.
You don't gotta be locked into one side, man.
Yeah.
Just feel good about what you're doing for the right people.
And it's great because this is a country where I may vote Republican, you may vote Democrat,
amen,
or vice versa.
Yep.
And you know what? I don't feel like killing you.
No.
Because you vote different than I do. A lot of places in the world, that's very possible that I'd have to kill this man if he didn't vote the same way I did. Maybe one day, maybe not. But
if
we've got
some. If you were going to kill me, what would you kill me with?
Oh, jeez, that's great.
You'd probably be a gun.
Yeah, gun's good. I don't know. Oh, jeez.
I think I would have to do it on some sort of thing like a car bomb. Like, I wouldn't be there.
That's popular.
You know, where you hit the ignition and you blow up.
That's good, yeah. You know, I don't know.
Because I couldn't do it face-to-face, probably.
I
couldn't be like,
yeah,
you're done.
Yeah, I think maybe
consider this a divorce.
I don't know. I'll have to think about that and talk to my lawyer before.
Flamethrower?
Flamethrower? Nah, dude, I don't want to see you run around. You might, like, try to tackle me or something. Maybe throw you in a frozen lake. That'd be good. Yeah.
Clawing at the ice.
Yeah. I'd stand there with a pick or something. Hey, do you want this? Do you need this? Here, just take it. Here.
I'm down there with some.
Why,
like,
won't you take it?
I'm down there with some seals.
Yeah. Oh, that's good too. Get the animal. Yeah, throw you off the boat.
Yeah, get some polar bears smelling me out. All right. Today we're talking about politics and sports. Do politics belong in sports? Los Suns or Los Suns? But why wouldn't they say sun as
in Spanish?
El
also.
Sol or whatever. Isn't it?
Yeah, that's the genius part.
Anyway, do politics belong in sports? Is sports a platform to talk about politics or to promote a political ideology?
No goddamn way, no way. There's an Arizona immigration bill right now, and what you have is you have. People from the Major League Baseball, and you have people from the NBA, not the executives of the league, but from players and teams in the leagues, and they're voicing opinions on whether or not this immigration bill is a good thing, bad thing, whether or not they should travel to that state to play sports because,
yeah,
they might get arrested.
Take the All-Star game out of it
something? Yeah, All-Star game in 2011 is in Arizona. And I'm saying that it's really dangerous for these leagues because when you start poking your head in on political issues, because something especially like immigration is very, very sensitive to a lot of people.
Especially there.
Yeah, especially in Arizona. And if you have a group like Major League Baseball or the NBA, even if it's not the league itself, just the players, saying, yes, we should support the bill, or no, we should not, support the law, we should rescind it. You may turn off some fans to the sport, and it's such a touchy subject, you may just straight up lose them. They might, I'll never watch, basketball again, that kind of attitude. What do you think?
I'm with you. I think that athletes have a unique ability to be able to promote their idea. Okay, so I love Jordan. I grew up a Jordan fan. Everybody wanted Jordan to talk about this. Everybody wanted Jordan to be like Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali spoke his mind about this, that, and the other, and they wanted the same thing from Jordan. They wanted the same thing from, different guys, I don't know. I think that athletes have a unique opportunity to maybe be a little bit political about their own theory. But you know what, man? this is America. This is a place where you have the right to say what your opinion is, and you have the right for other people to not be so damn swayed by your opinion. If Charles Barkley tells me he's a Republican, I'm not going to be a Republican tomorrow. But if Charles Barkley tells me to, you know, get the ball up when I'm down low, I'm going to get the ball up when I'm down. I mean, whatever. Yeah. I'm just saying, I think that you need to stick to with what you know. We don't come on here and start talking about politics. I know about a little bit about politics. You know a little bit about politics, but that's not the stuff that we're into. I know about what's happening in sports. You know about what's happening in sports. Yeah. You guys know what's happening in sports. That's why you watch this stuff. And so it's one of those series of, for me, stick to what you know. You know, stick to what you're good at. You know, and the Suns, if the Suns want to talk about something that is affecting the state, you know, I think they have a right to do it because it's America.
Yeah, yeah.
But whether they have the right to influence all those people and have all those people be influenced, because I personally see America as a great opportunity, the land of opportunity, but I see America as also full of sheep, full of people who are just like, where do I go today?
I was at the mall today.
Where do I go today?
I know exactly what he's talking about.
Yeah, what do I wear? How do I wear it? What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to wear a new era hat? Okay, well, how do I wear it? Do I tilt it? Just wear it how you want to wear it. I wear my stuff exactly how I want to wear it. You want to clown on me? Clown on me all you want. I'm going to wear it tomorrow the same way because I don't give a damn what everybody else thinks.
Yeah.
I can do how I want to do, and that's why I live here. This is what's great about our country.
Yeah.
It's also the point, have your own mind. Make up your own mind.
Yeah.
You like the Suns, and you don't like the you like the Suns, and you like the immigration bill? You can like them both. You don't gotta hate the Suns because they didn't support the immigration bill.
Yeah.
I'm never gonna support the Suns again. You liked the Suns on Tuesday. You didn't like them on Wednesday because they supported some bill. Get over it.
Yeah. Yeah, and like you're
saying, balance, man.
Yeah, and you know, there's people out there, like we were saying, that are super sensitive. Like, let's say, you know, some guy for the, you know, Yankees came out and said, like, you know, I'm not for abortion.
Right.
Very sensitive subject.
Huge.
I would suggest not mentioning
your
opinion. And at the same time, if you want to, you have every right
feel
to.
Feel free.
If, you know, everybody applauds you and loves you for it, you know, super. If everybody...
If you think that a catcher's opinion is that important, go with it.
Yeah.
But a catcher's opinion shouldn't be that important.
Yeah.
A point guard's opinion shouldn't be that important. Especially a point guard from Canada.
Yeah, I know. That was the best part, dude. I heard Nash talking about it. And I was thinking, dude, you're not even an American. Why are you even talking about this? Yeah.
I can see the owner's point of view. The owner wants to do something, fine. Let the owner do something.
Yeah.
But you know, and even let Amari wants to talk about it, fine, whatever. But I'm not going to necessarily go out and vote any certain way because of what Amari told me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to think how I'm going to think, and I'm going to have my own opinions.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the whole point.
Yeah, and like you're saying about sheeple, we do live in a country with a lot of followers where there are people that will not watch the Suns or that will...
Let this thing ruin what they liked before.
Yeah. So I mean, it's it's reality. I mean, there are people that will see some superstar on TV, you know, friggin' going to Taco Bell, so they go to Taco Bell because they like that actor, you know. So I mean, it's full of people.
They like that little dog.
No, I was thinking, I don't know. I was going to say perfume, but I, you know, wasn't sure, like, who does perfume now. And I'm old, and I'm really uncool.
I think I saw Lamar Odom on a Taco Bell commercial.
Really?
With, was he on the one with Chuck?
Ooh, that's right. Yeah, he was. All that bog for lots and lots and not so much. Or,
terrible.
I don't know. Yeah,
one of the worst commercials I've ever seen. And they were, like, promoting it, like, I was like, ooh, watch for more.
Yeah, I like the McDonald's commercials. During the Olympics, that show all the Olympians eat just mowing McDonald's, you know, while they're at the
training.
Olympics. Yeah, because, you know, that's pretty much the diet of an Olympic athlete.
That's the Olympian food.
Yeah, they love the...
They got the logo on the side of the cup.
Yeah, da-da-da-da-da.
All right, folks. For all those people out there, I support the new initiative, Make the Rocky Theme the National Anthem. Peace.